Okay, so we know from ANOVA that somebody's different. At least one group is different. Like I said earlier, ANOVA will tell you if there's a difference between the groups, but it's not going to tell you which groups are different from each other. For this, we're going to need that multiple comparison task, and we're going to use Fisher's LSD because that's what we programmed into TC stats. Now, here's the basic idea of Fisher's LSD. Again, there's much more detail in your textbook, but essentially what's going to happen is it's going to create confidence intervals. And let's say the first confidence interval would be group one versus group two. So if I do a confidence interval for the difference of these two means, what I'm looking for is zero in the interval. If my confidence interval looks like this, or zero simply somewhere in the interval, then we say that there's no evidence to suggest that the mean of group one, think of the mean of group one minus the mean of group two, there's no reason to think that they're any different. Now, if we do another one, say groups one and three, mean of one minus the mean of group three, and let's just say it looks like this. Now, zero is not in the interval. So that's saying that these guys are, in fact, different. So I now know that groups one and three are different, but one and two are not. It's that type of logic that we're going to look for. Now, right away, you're probably going to say, well, wait a minute, time out. There's a problem here. Earlier, we said the reason we do ANOVA is because if I have alpha 0.05 for each t-test, then my true alpha for the whole procedure is going to be huge if I do multiple t-tests. And ANOVA helps to control that. So what gives me the right to go ahead now and do a bunch of confidence intervals? Isn't that the same idea as doing a bunch of t-tests? And the answer is, well, sort of. But there's two things going on here. The way the confidence intervals are built are a little bit different from what we've done before. And again, the details are in the textbook, so you can take a look at that. And the other thing is that the p-values as such are what we call protected. They're protected p-values, meaning we're not going to do this Fisher's LSD unless there's a significant p-value for the ANOVA to begin with, hence the protection. Because you may be thinking, well, gosh, why not simply start with Fisher's LSD and skip this whole idea of the ANOVA? Why go through all of that if I'm just going to end up using Fisher's LSD anyway? And the reason being is it's been shown that if you just simply jump to a multiple comparison test without protecting it first with the results of ANOVA, then the probability of having a false positive, I guess is one way of thinking of it, is much greater than the alpha that you're thinking of there, or the alpha that you want, that 0.05. So we're not even going to look at Fisher's LSD unless we first know that ANOVA says, yeah, somebody's different, go figure out who. That's what I mean by this protected p-value. So the way that TC stats handle this is actually kind of cool. First thing I'm going to do is I have the ANOVA set up just like I did earlier. There's no change there. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add to it Fisher's LSD. I'm going to turn it on and I'm going to tell it that I want a 95% confidence level. In other words, alpha is 0.05. Now when I update it, I get this matrix down here in the bottom. So the key is, how do you read the matrix? Well, remember I said if zero was in the interval, then they're not different. Well, the only way for zero to be in the interval is if the left endpoint is negative and the right endpoint is positive. So if I have a negative on the left, positive on the right, zero's in the middle. If I have both of them positive, then I know I'm above. If I have both of them negative, then I know I'm below. Either way, zero is not in the interval. So looking at this matrix from TC Stats, I see a negative and a positive. One and two are not different from each other. One and three, these are negative. I'm sorry, they're bold and they're both positive. Well, the fact that the bold is supposed to be bringing out to you or kind of highlighting to you that these guys are different. They're positive, so there is a difference between one and three. And then two and three is also highlighted. So this is saying that there's a difference between diet two and diet three. So one and three are different, two and three are different, one and two are not. Which is what we sort of suspected but couldn't confirm by looking at these box plots. See, one and two are not different, one and three, two and three are. And that was kind of the big question. We knew that one and three was going to be. We just wasn't 100% that one or two and three would be. And we didn't know what was going to happen between one and two. So now we know that these two are not different, but three are different from both of these guys. That's what the multiple comparison test does for you. It helps you identify which of the groups are different from each other.